Are you also like me who suffers a lot of hair fall in monsoons, dull, dry and frizzy hair? I guess then you're at the right place because I'm going to show you this hair mask which has helped me over the years to overcome this and tackle the adversities of monsoons. So I'm going to share this hair mask with you which will help you get softer, shinier and straighter hair. And I have not even used a conditioner right now, not even a serum. My hair are just being shampooed, that's it, after the hair mask. And they look so much tamed and, you know, straighter and shinier. So I hope you will like it and please subscribe if you haven't already. Welcome back to my channel, guys. As you all know that monsoons have kicked off. It has really taken a toll over our hair and it has led to dry hair, dull hair, frizzy hair, hair fall and you know what not, like literally monsoons. I hate you for this. Anyway, I have a remedy for you, so I'm going to share this banana hair mask with you. Of course, the first ingredient is going to be banana. Now, bananas are really rich in potassium, natural oils, vitamins, carbohydrates, and all of this helps in fighting dull, frizzy hair, dry hair. It helps in preventing split ends, overcoming split ends, and also it helps in fighting hair fall. So one ingredient helps you fight a lot of things basically. So I'm going to take half a banana. It depends on your on the length of your hair. If you have longer hair than me, take more. If you have shorter hair than me, take a lesser quantity. Now what you're going to do is you need to make a puree out of your banana. Now make sure that you're using a mixer, not doing it with your hands, because that'll lead to clumps and that'll get stuck in your hair and it'll be very difficult to wash it off. So it's better you make a puree out of it. Use a little bit of curd, that'll help you make it make the process smoother. So I'm going to add a spoon of curd in my puree. Now curd is, you know, rich in vitamin B3 and proteins. Now it's a natural source of protein for your hair, and again it helps in, you know, fighting your dull dry hair, and it helps in hair boosting hair growth and also helps you fighting hair fall. So I'm going to take you know, this much of it, all right, and I'm going to add it to the mixer. I've already used a little bit earlier because I had to, you know, make a puree out of it. So yeah, I'll be taking it that much. And next ingredient that I'm going to use is, the weather is so humid, I cannot even tell you, and I cannot switch on the fan or the AC because that will lead to disturbance in the video, and I am sweating like hell. Damn. Anyway, let's just do this fatafat. So next ingredient that I'm going to take is almost this much of honey. Now honey is, now honey is a natural moisturizer. Now we all know that honey leads to, you know, basically it improves the health of the of our hair follicles. It's a natural moisturizer. It gives, you know, it helps in conditioning your hair. It helps to add a lot of shine and helps in, you know, recovering from split ends as well. So honey is a must, you know, in such hair masks. Now for all those who are suffering from dandruff, they can add a little bit of lemon as well. I'm going to add because lemon also gives a lot of shine, and it's better to prevent, you know, to avoid dandruff right now. I had dandruff, a little bit of dandruff a couple of months ago, so I'm just taking a precautionary step. I don't want dandruff again, so yeah. And I have 2 spoons in the bowl, don't mind that. Anyway, so the next ingredient is going to be this Sattva premium hair oil. Now this is like all in one. Now this oil includes almond oil, castor oil, coconut oil, grapeseed oil, emu oil, amla oil, jojoba oil, vitamin E and olive oil. Like these are all the oils that I would you know, try separately. Like I already use olive, coconut, castor, almond, jojoba. I don't use the grapeseed or emu or amla oil, but amla I'm definitely keen to use. So these are all the good oils like in one, so I would like go with this one. And it also helps in slowing premature graying. So if you're someone who is in your, you know, late 30s or something and you have started getting your gray hair, then you definitely should use it. It also helps in promoting hair growth, prevents dandruff, stops hair fall. So if you want to know more about this hair oil, then I'll link it up here and you can go and check out their website and know more about the hair oil as well. Now I'm going to add this one because this basically covers everything and has everything in it. So I'm gonna use just a little bit of it so that I also get the the nurturing of hair oil. So I'm just gonna take like a spoon of it, that's it. And once I'm done, I'm going to mix everything really well and then show you the end result. Please ignore how I look, guys. Like, I know I'm sweating and I look like shit right now, like seriously, but anyway, so I mixed everything together very nicely and this is how my mixture looks like. So make sure you don't have any clumps of banana, otherwise God save you guys, it's really difficult to get rid of it. So I have already tried it, you know, when I started using this one initially I did it and damn, you don't want to get into all of that, see, trust me. So make sure it's really really nicely mixed like this, and now I'm going to show you how to apply it and then I'll show you the end result after I wash it. So I'm not going to do anything special, I'm just going to make random partitions and then apply the mixture with my hands only, because that's the easiest way. And I'm going to first apply it on my scalp and massage it into it so that all the goodness of the ingredients is, you know, digested by my scalp. And then whatever is remaining I'm going to use on the lengths of my hair because I don't want any part of my hair to be deprived of it. And the process is pretty simple, I'm just going to massage it on the lengths of my hair. I've done that off camera actually, so that's why I'm explaining you. It's pretty simple what I'm doing with the scalp, I'm going to do with the lengths of my hair, that's it. So once you're done, keep it for 20 minutes or something and don't let it dry completely. Let it be a little moist before you shampoo. And this is how my hair looks once I have shampooed them. You know, they felt so soft and shiny, like it felt like my hair came back to life. So yeah, I really enjoyed shooting this video for you guys. I hope it will help you in some way or the other, and if it really does, then please leave your comments down below. If you happen to use it, then let me know how did it help you. And do not forget to subscribe for more amazing videos and like this video, share it with your friends, spread some love around, and I will see you next time. Bye bye, take care, I love you all so much.